Good morning, children. So today also we are going to see about your history first chapter, the continuation version. Okay, how, when, and where. Okay, welcome you all for history class. Yes, children. So this chapter, how, when, and where. So in the last class, or the previous, you know, the session, we have discussed about why this history is synonymous with dates, how dates are very much important. Okay, and then what we understood about, you know, what are the criteria to be considered as a date as a important one, and about the, yes, in, you know, the Indian history, the British people wrote Indian history, the consideration of their governor general. Okay, who's the first governor general? Yes, children. Yes, that is, you know, the general Warren Hastings. And who's the last, you know, the viceroy? Mountbatten. So finally, we understood about how it is the dates are important, and, you know, the history is synonymous with the dates, and not only the dates, other things are also very much important in history. So it may be when the things has happened, when the issue has happened, or where exactly, you know, the one event or the battle has happened, all those things we will be studying in history. Okay, in today's session, you know, we'll be seeing about the criteria to periodize, and then prior to British rule, before British rule came to India, how was the situation? That is the prior to British rule, and then the classification of Indian history. So how we have classified Indian history, on what basis, that we are going to see today, and the time notation. So it is not there in your, you know, the book. You have studied this time notation from long, you know, even in your 6th standard, 4th standard, 5th standard, all this. Just for a re-glance, today we are going to see about time notation, and then change of modern period to colonial period. So from the modern, you know, the period of history, we have changed that to colonial period. Why we started to call that period as a colonial period? And what do you mean by the colonies, or the colonized areas, that we are going to see today? Okay, children. Yes. Next, we are going to see about the criteria to periodize. See here. In 1817, a Scottish economist and political philosopher named James Mill has written the very big book, published a book called History of British India. Okay, children. So, you know, James Mill was a Scottish economist and the political philosopher, has wrote a book. The name is History of British India. Guys, remember, History of British India. So in his book, it is a massive book. Okay, so in his book, he has written the lot of things about Indian history, about history of India. And in this book, he has divided the Indian history into three periods. Okay, in that we can see the first period, it is Hindu, Muslim, and the British. Okay, children, the James Mill is a Scottish economist and a political philosopher. He has, you know, wrote a book, that is History of British India. In his book, he has divided the Indian history into three periods. Okay, one, it is Hindu, Muslim, and the British. Okay, fine, children. Once we start seeing about dividing history into three parts, or the three periods, okay, why we have divided this into three periods, history into three periods, how it is helpful, what it exactly shows. For example, here what happens, from one period to another period, whatever the changes which has happened, okay, why we have divided, you know, the history into three, you know, the period wise, because to know the changes which has happened from one period to another period. Okay, children, just remember, we have divided history into the periods because to know the changes or to understand the changes which happened from one period to another period. Okay, so we can see, according to James Mill, he has divided the Indian history into three parts, are the three periods. One, it is Hindu period, Muslim period, and the British period. Okay, children, once we started dividing history in, you know, based on the caste or the religion, is it good? Is it, you know, acceptable by the people? Let us see that. Okay, see here. Yes, prior to the British rule. So before the British people came to India, how was the Indian situation? See, before Britishers took over India, there were Hindu and Muslim rulers who used to exploit India. So here what they are telling, as we know, India, we were following the very, you know, yesterday also we have seen that, the caste system. Yes or no, children? So in the Vedic period, you know, that we'll call it as a Varna system. In Hinduism, they were following this caste system, and we had the different, diverse religions also in our country. Okay, see, that is the reason here they are telling, before the British people came to India, took over the India, so that time Hindu and this Muslim rulers, those people were exploiting the India. Okay, by taking the resources for the developmental activities and all, they were exploiting the India. Furthermore, India strongly believed in caste system, multiple religions, and the superstitions, etc. So of course, as we know that, as we Indians, we believed about the caste system. Yesterday we have seen that, and the multiple religions. So we could have seen, you know, the different religions in our country and the superstitious beliefs the people have got. Okay, so that is the reason what happened, you know, the James Mill, whatever he has divided the Indian history into, yes, the three periods. So he started to think that Asia is not much civilized than compared to the European countries. Okay, the Asian countries were not civilized than compared to the European countries. Okay, so that is the reason what he started to believe. He started to believe, or he felt that only the British rule could civilize India. Okay, so James Mill, according to James Mill, you know, he felt that only the British rule could civilize India and teach them manners, arts, and laws. Okay, so because he believed that, you know, the European countries are more civilized than Asian countries, because in India and all, we were still following the, you know, the multiple religions, we were following some superstitious beliefs, along with that we were following some caste system. Understand, children? Okay, fine, we can see here the three, you know, the divisions are the periods we have divided the Indian history according to James Mill. See here, can we refer to any period of history as Hindu or Muslim? So what happens here, whatever the faith or the beliefs they have got into their religion, that will not be same to the all the religions. Yes or no, children? So here what happened, we can't, you know, periodize the history based on the religion, because their own beliefs, their own faith, their own followings will be different from religion to religion. Okay, children, fine, let's move on to the next slide. See here, the time notation. So finally, this concept you people have studied from your earlier classes also, just re-glance this, okay? So usually we can see that years, whenever we are mentioning the years, we can see the two things. One it is before Christ and one more it is after Christ, usually we'll call. So that will be called as a Anno Domini. See here, the terms Anno Domini, that is AD, and before Christ, that is BC, are used to label our number years in the Julian or, you know, the Gregorian calendars. So usually we'll be using Anno Domini or the before Christ. Okay. So if you see, what do you mean by the term Anno Domini mean? It means, you know, is a medieval Latin. It means that in the years of the Lord, they'll call it as a after the, you know, the birth of, yes, Jesus Christ. So if it is a before Christ, means an epoch used in dating years prior to the estimated birth of Jesus. So before the birth of Jesus. So we can see that here, if we come to BC, yes, we can go to the, you know, the decreasing level, okay, descending order of our years. And if we come to AD, Anno Domini, we can see the ascending orders. Okay, children, just re-glance this. And then we can see that Indian history has again, they started to classify based on the British people. So already we have seen that the James Mill has divided the Indian history into three periods. The one it is, yes children, that is Hindu, Muslim and the British, based on the religion he has divided. But whatever the, you know, he has divided, he started to believe, you know, the Asian countries or India can be civilized only by the rule of this British people. Okay, he started to believe that only a British can bring the civilized country in India, and they can bring the proper law, equality and some of the developmental activities. But what happened? The British rule was showing that the progress and the civilization. Guys, remember, the British rule was focusing more on, yes, the progress and the civilization. Okay. So that's the reason they started to believe only a British rule can make or grow the country, or develop or civilize the country. Okay, children. So later, you know, the many British people, and you know, they started again to divide Indian history based on the, again, three division we can see. One it is, yes, that is ancient history, medieval history and the modern history. So by the name itself, it is denoting ancient. Children, what do you mean by ancient? Yes, it is an, you know, the earlier stage of our history. What happened, how it has happened, when it has happened, we used to see about the earlier stage. Okay, then the coming to the medieval history. What do you mean by the medieval history? Yes, children, medieval history, where the modern, you know, the facilities or the modern thoughts were not existed in this period of time. That will be called as a medieval history. And then the coming to the modern history. What do you mean by modern? The name itself, it is denoting modern. Yes, that means whatever the changes which is happening, the development or the growth we can see, it may be in the name of, yes, it may be the freedom, it may be the democracy and other activities, developmental activities in the country, maybe from the education, all those things will be considered as a modern. Equality, legislature, all those things. Okay, see, you know, the time and all is not mentioned in your textbook, so just make a note of this. Okay, children, see, ancient history, the time period from, yes, 4000 BC to AD, 500 AD, and then the medieval history is denoting, yes, 500 AD to 1500 AD, and then the modern history is denoting 1500 500 AD and at present situation also.